By the end of this video, you will know how to use the auto grading function in Clo3D to grade multiple sizes for a basic top, easy step by step. We will grade this top from an extra small to a medium size by using the auto grading function in Clo3D. Then save that graded pattern for the future. Okay, I'm here in Clo to grade this top pattern to 3 sizes. I'm going to first show you some guideline here. So this step right here will apply to any grading in Clo3D that use auto grading function. Okay, so I will point out a few important things here. That step number one, convert unnecessary point to curve points. Save the project file as Garmin first before you can grade your pattern or it doesn't work. And select the avatar sizes and so on. Next, I'm going to come back to Clo and show you some quick and easy way on how to grade this top using auto function. Okay, first of all, I'm going to point out which points are necessary and which aren't. So this point right here aren't necessary because they are curve point, and we can turn that to a curve point without have to affect the design itself. And right here, this point right here is important for the next to create this V shape rather than oval. So we won't convert this point here, but we will convert, for example, this point here, we will convert them to curve point. So it will have a better result for this top, okay? So to do that, I'm going to once again kind of zoom in a little bit closer to that point that we are going to convert. Then I'm going to come over here to this 2D toolbar and select this edit pattern tool, click on it, and then hover the mouse to the right and select edit pattern tool. Then I'm going to marquee select all these points, right click, and select convert to curve points. Just like that. Next, I'm going to come down here. Once again, marquee selects all these points right here, right click, and then select convert to curve points. Okay. And I'm going to come over here as well. I will also convert this point as well to curve point. And then more right here to curve points. Okay, then I'm going to come down here. Let's say so those are converted also as well. Okay, so now I'm going to save the pattern to a Garmin file. To do that, I'm going to come over here to file, click on it, then save as, and hover the mouse to the right and select Garmin. And I'm going to name it Garmin. Okay. And then top 2. After that, I'm going to create a folder as well. So create a folder for top graded top 2. Why not? And underscore XS2M. We want to grade it 3 sizes from XS, S to M. Okay, then I'm going to click on create. After that, I'm going to click on save. Alright, next I'm going to marquee, select all the pattern pieces, and I'm going to press down the delete key on the keyboard to delete. Okay, now I'm going to add that Garmin file back to the workspace. To do that, I'm going to come back to file and I'm going to select add right here and then hover the mouse to the right and select Garmin. Okay, so this is the Garmin top that we saved earlier. I'm going to select on that file, okay? Then come down here and click open. Okay, here, this open post and side window pop up. Would you like to load the avatar post and side file? Why not? Say yes. Okay, so since I draft this garment onto that avatar, it fit just perfect. If somehow your garments like hang up like this, doesn't fit really well, we have this button right here, 3D draping. Click on that button, it will redrape onto this avatar. Like perfect, okay? Just one click, guys, just like that. Next, I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. Okay, so now these pattern pieces right here are a garment file. It's not a project's file because over here, if I look at over here, .zpac. So that is a garment file, okay? And over here, I'm going to do a couple things here. Follow to the step down here that I have listed under the video description. So select the avatar size, that we will do next, and we save the project's file as garment. We just did that already. Deleting the project, we did that, and add the garments file back to the workspace, we did that. Next right here, change the particle distance to 20 millimeter, guy, and then we are going to come back to Chloe and I will show you how to do that. Okay, so right here, we already turned all the points that unnecessary to curve points. Next, I'm going to change the particle distance on this garment to 20. To do that, I'm going to come over here to this transform pattern tool, click on it to select. Then I can either marquee, select all that pattern pieces, or let me click one on the page, or I can command or control plus letter A to select all that pattern pieces, okay? And come to this property editor. And as you can see, my particle distance here, if you first land in and you don't see that, you just click on that slider and scroll it down here. And see this particle distance 5, I'm going to click and then highlight it and then type in 20. Then press return enter on the keyboard to confirm. Okay, so now particle distance is 20. I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. Okay, so we just change the particle distance on this top to 20. Next, I'm going to distance these pattern pieces a little bit far from each other, okay? So we are going to either marquee select the pattern pieces like that, or you just click and then drag it up like that, okay? The same right here, same right here, rather. Then I'm going to just, you know, click and then drag, probably whichever easier for you, because we want this as far from one another. Then I'm going to kind of, let's just marquee select all these pattern pieces and move it back to the right just a little bit. We want it enough space when this pattern graded upside, all the pattern pieces will expand, okay? Now I think that's about right. I think I hide something here. So the next part here, click it, drag it up a little bit, and then click on here. Just like that, okay? All right, let me move this neck back down here a little bit, the neck bands, and then right here a little bit for the hem bands, as well as this hem band. You know, make it somewhat that, kind of a little clean and a little organized. So after we spacing all these patterns pieces from one another, now this is awesome thing, guys. We are going to come over here to this objects browser and click on this grading icon, okay, right there. Then I'm going to come down here, you see this add button right there, click on it to add this side group. Then, as you can see, we have size 1. We are going to add 2 more sizes, which is come over here to this right side right there, this plus button right there, click on it twice. Now we have side 1, side 2, side 3. So the name itself kind of a little bit boring. We want to change it to a little bit more fancier, which is double click on it. Then I'm going to type in XS, okay? Then press on the tab key and then type in S, press on the tab key and then type in M. After that, I'm going to press on return or enter on the keyboard to confirm. Okay, so as you can see down here, each side has its own color. You can change that color down here by just click on it to change to however color you like. But for me, I don't really concern much about the colors. I only concern about the sizes. So size X, S, S, M, that is perfect for me. Thanks so much for watching, Designista. I hope you find this video useful. And remember to sub and click on the bell for more awesome videos. Thank you.